Hi everyone, my name is Pauline. As a nuclear medicine resident, I see a lot of people with thyroid diseases. This is why I made a series of videos in which I explain everything related to the thyroid, from physiology to pathology to some important diagnostic tools. This is the last video in a series of four teaching videos about the thyroid gland. In this video, we'll talk about a thyroid scan and the use of radioactive iodine. A thyroid scan is a nuclear medicine examination that uses a radioactive tracer and a special camera to measure how much tracer the thyroid gland absorbs from the blood. A thyroid scan shows the size, shape, and location of the thyroid gland. It can also find areas of the thyroid gland that are overactive or underactive. A thyroid scan consists of three phases: tracer administration, taking images, and image interpretation. The amount of time between administration of the tracer and the taking of the images may range from a few moments to a few days. The time depends on the tracer being used. The tracer used in this test is either technetium or radioactive iodine. Technetium is more widely used than iodine because of its availability and cost. You will either swallow a dose of iodine 24 hours before the scan or be given technetium intravenously in your arm 20 to 30 minutes before the scan. The wait time of 30 minutes to 24 hours is necessary to allow the tracer to be taken up by the thyroid gland and emit radiation. The camera sees the radiation and can measure how much tracer the thyroid absorbs from the blood. When the patient has a thyroid scan, he or she will be lying down on a bed and the camera will be positioned very close over their head. The total scanning time is about 10 to 15 minutes. The tracer uptake within thyroid cells corresponds with thyroid activity as the radioactive tracer mimics normal iodine uptake in the gland. Tracer uptake is usually low or absent in thyroiditis. Autonomously functioning nodules appear as focal areas of increased uptake, and Graves' disease presents as diffuse and symmetrical uptake throughout both lobes. Salivary glands are visible in the upper neck of each figure, but are seen only faintly in panels C and D as a result of the relative intensity of uptake in the thyroid gland. It is important to note that the tracer iodine is made in two radioactive forms: iodine 123, which is harmless to thyroid cells and is used to visualize the thyroid gland. It is a good alternative to technetium. The second form is iodine 131. Iodine 131 destroys thyroid cells and is used to treat thyroid cancer and Graves' disease. So to summarize, iodine 123 and technetium are two radioactive tracers that are used for diagnostic purposes. Iodine 131, on the other hand, is a radioactive drug. It destroys thyroid tissue and is therefore often used for the treatment of thyroid cancer or Graves' disease. The therapy is most effective if you have high blood levels of TSH, which causes thyroid cells, including thyroid cancer cells, to take up the iodine. This can be done in one of two ways. The first is by stopping thyroid hormone pills for 3 to 6 weeks. This causes high levels of TSH to be produced by our body naturally. This results in hypothyroidism, which may involve symptoms such as fatigue, cold intolerance, and others. To minimize the symptoms of hypothyroidism, you can prescribe T3. This is a short-acting form of thyroid hormone that is usually taken after T4 is stopped until 2 weeks before the radioactive iodine treatment. Alternatively, TSH can be increased sufficiently without stopping thyroid hormone medication by injecting a synthetic form of TSH into your body. The benefit of this approach is that the patient can continue taking the thyroid hormone medication and avoid possible symptoms related to hypothyroidism. Although the treatment with iodine 131 is considered to be safe, radioactive iodine produces radiation, so patients must do their best to avoid radiation exposure to others, particularly to pregnant women and young children. Depending on the dose, patients may have to stay isolated in the hospital for about 2 to 4 days to avoid exposing other people to radiation. If a patient is undergoing therapy for an overactive thyroid gland, he or she will generally not experience any side effects from the treatment as the dose is quite low. If a patient is undergoing therapy following removal of the thyroid as a result of cancer, he or she may experience some side effects, including a dry mouth and pain in the salivary glands. The effect of this treatment on the thyroid gland usually takes between 1 and 3 months to develop. Maximum benefit occurs 3 to 6 months after treatment. Usually, a single dose is successful in treating hyperthyroidism. The end result is often hypothyroidism, which is treated by thyroid hormone replacement. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you want to see more of my videos where I explain various medical topics in an easy and understandable way, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell button if you want to get notified every time I upload a video. If after watching these series of videos you still have questions about the thyroid gland, please leave a comment below.